Alrighty. Sadly, as with any speedrun marathon, all good things come to an end, but what better way to end off a marathon than a game where technically in universe, in the setting, everything's technically already ended? That joke sounded better in my head, but I'm gonna roll with it. Hi folks, I'm R30Hedron, here to close things off with Into the Breach. If you are unfamiliar with the game, it is basically giant mechs against giant kaiju insects on a chessboard. It is a fantastic little speed game, and we're going to toss in a little bit of extra randomness into an already random-heavy game. So, the pilot's probably going to be fixed. We're probably going to stick with good old Kazak, who is a bit of a cameo from the other game Subset Games created, FTL Faster Than Light. But we're going to go ahead and grab a random squad. That is an interesting random squad. Normally, we don't do random squads because random squads are basically equivalent to a custom squad when you're doing a speedrun setting, but for this, it makes sense. It's perfect. It also technically is a tiny spoiler. I apologize. We're going to have a bug on our team. And sadly, Kazak can't ride the bug into battle. Can insects wear cowboy hats? Does that. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and change the color as well to something fancy. We'll do nice and green. Keep it simple. But I think we're set to go. If we are ready on the timer. Time starts when we hit the start button. So let's go. So for speedrunning Into the Breach, my first priority is going to be heading to one of the two islands that we're going to be doing, which is going to be RST and Archive. And we already have our first relatively quick mission. This is a Cataclysm mission. We'll have nice little environmental effects slowly eating away at the game board. And what will make things nice and quick for us, hopefully, is that we can do some nice blocks. And it'll be one turn shorter than traditional as well, which is good. For this sort of game, we want to keep animations at a minimum. Keep things nice and quick. I think that is fine, and then we'll toss a rock. Oh, this is gonna throw me off slightly because I'm used to speedrunning squads that are, more traditional than this. This is a random squad, which is I'm kind of relying on old 100% speedrun strats here. This is going to be interesting. So, what you saw me do at the end of the last mission there was a quick escape to main menu and continue. That lets us skip some animation cycles, which is huge. Over the course of a run, it adds up. Let's do that. That scorpion's staying alive a little bit longer than I would like, but we should be good after this, I believe. Yep, I've got enough movement to do that. And that. I'm already trying to think of what I want to do as far as like power cores. Shield stealth could be good on Aegis. Flying would be good on Aegis. Defend the train would be good. Let's defend the train. I need to think. I think I want to get the extra damage on our scarab friend. I think that's highest priority. Gonna do that. And actually purposely take some damage to grid there. And block the bomb. We are gonna lose the train, but that is actually on purpose. The train is a little slow. So if we can kill the train while also killing an Alpha Vec, then that's extra goodies for us. Goodies are good. The train missions are the other nice short missions that we're looking for, since they are one turn shorter. And getting one shorter turn is always a benefit in my eyes. I think our best bet is just going to be emergency batteries. This one should be a nice quick one, and after that we should go off to the next section. That's a mild annoyance at best, but I think this'll be fine. We've got more than enough damage to be able to cope with some of the stuff going on here with this mission, I believe. Yeah, this should be pretty quick. I was hoping I was gonna be able to block. Couldn't see anything quick enough. The Scion is one that we can just leave be, though. Except he was in the way, so I had to get rid of him. Bit of a shame. I'm not completely heartless. If the Scion's not attacking me, why do I need to attack the Scion, right? I can actually get one tile, but let me go ahead and do this first. We've got goo. Do I want to kill the goo? Well, I think we'll just do goo babysitting duty. I'll block the spawn with a rock. Do I have enough movement to do? No, I do not. Let's just move out of the way then. Was not able to move fast enough to get that, but that's fine. It's just a Scion. The Scion is pretty harmless, honestly. And we'll block this. We'll move them out of the way. Nice! Pretty painless, that mission, I would say. Spend rep. Let's grab one core and something to sell for the next island. Honestly, just get me the damage, and I think that'll be fine. So, moving on now to Archive. This is our sort of Green Hill zone. I think this will give me the best options to look at here, I think, for different mission types. And it's a burrower! Who knows? Burrowers are slow, and I can't move them. Burrowers. On the bright side, we should have the extra damage on you. Just murder outright. The extra damage is going to come in handy, I would say. Let's do this to get a block. Move you out of the way and then swipe. A bit fancy of a turn, I will admit, but it worked, and work is the most important part. Let's go there, let's go there, and let's go there. We got a full block on the final turn. That is nice and quick, I would say. Hit to the main menu and continue to continue, and let's see what we've got. Satellite launches and block Vex spawns. I think we'll go here then. I don't think I'm going to be lucky and get all four of the fast missions that I want. I don't think we have the train mission on Archive this time around. That's the main reason why we pick Archive and RST, is simply just because we get the greatest chance of having the quickest missions. A little bit slow there, having to deal with the burrower animation cycle there. We should be able to get a swipe here. Get the kill there, and a block. This is working surprisingly smoothly, and I don't know how I feel about that. I was expecting a random squad to be a little bit tougher. Admittedly, trying to reframe how I speedrun this game with a squad that I'm not familiar with has definitely been a fun challenge. I've been enjoying it. Self-destruct, yes, please. That is going to be useful in a pinch. Less than three grid, not a mission I want to take. We'll go here instead. Self-destruct is going to be extremely useful because it's basically just a I push the button and the thing in front of me dies button, which is for a mech that comes back to life when it dies. That's the one exception with the burrower, or sorry, with the scarab mecha I've got here. I'm gonna reset the turn there. I think there was a better play. Yeah, I wanted to do this instead because of the damage. There we go. That was quite a bit faster, I would say. I don't think I'm going to get the movement here. I am, and I killed my own bug. Oops. The nice thing is that we actually don't go by in-game time for the speedrun leaderboards. In-game time, I'm trying to think. I think at one point early on in the game's speedrun history, we were considering going by in-game time, but there is actually a disparity between the in-game time and the RTA time as far as like, well, timing. That sounded cooler in my head. So, Tidal Waves is the other nice, quick, and fast mission, which is fantastic, because we should be able to get a pretty quick turnaround on this, because we've been able to effectively delete one of the spawns, which is something we actually did with the Cataclysm mission on RST as well. Nice. And that's all four missions. Let's hop over now to the corporate headquarters. Firefly Leader. Let's see what we can do with you. What we can do with you is probably just babysit a little bit, actually. Or better yet, I did not power the self-destruct. I forgot the self-destruct requires power. On the bright side, babysitting is just as viable a strat with if you want to deal with if you want to deal with Vec that you can't outright kill. Let's move you to there. Slightly longer attack, so slightly longer animations, but it should be fine. Do you have enough movement to go where I want you to go? You do not. That is a problem. How do I want to do the. Ooh. I think that's just going to be better. We'll lose two grid instead of three. Bit of a shame that. So we'll sell that. I think we do have to sell Prospero here. One, two, and then power. Let's go ahead and give the power to you. Show damage on that. Actually, no. I think I'm going to do movement and movement. All right, and with that, the nice thing with Into the Breach is that you can pick the length of your run. We're going to do a two-island run. And indeed, as Skip has mentioned, grid is a resource. If you've got too much, if you only need one grid, you only need a little bit of power. All right, so this is going to be a little bit of focus time on my part because there is animation skips. Save and quit. We can skip a little bit of the environmental animations here. Instead of having four, we now only have two, which is quite nice. One of the community members for the Into the Breach community, Lemononymous, was the one that found that trick, so we kind of nicknamed it a Lemon Skip in their honor. We will just let the scorpion bite me? Question mark? All right, this is a perfect self-destruct, I think. Kaboom. It's okay. He's just mostly dead. If he was completely dead, then we'd have nothing to work with. But mostly dead, we can do something. He'll be fine. It's okay. All right, phase two. There is the debate on whether I just want to murder that bug instantly with the self-destructor or not here, but we will have to see. Bit of a shame that the Lemon Skip does kind of mess with the end game music here because it's some good music. We got two there. You are in a position that's going to be mildly annoying. Workable. Still annoying. Just block one spawn. We are gonna let these go so we can get rid of one of our spawns. You'll die to a sneeze from most of our mechs. This will be nice. I can hopefully get you to here. That Vec is dead. And this Vec will also be dead by proxy. This will turn into a lava tile, and you'll just go for a nice swim. I love it when this stuff sort of just works out. Don't need to do any more blocks of spawns, which is nice. I want to move you to there, move you to there, and we will get the kill on you. We are going to lose our mech here, but that's because I missed the repair, but it'll be fine because you will die to a nice little shove. All right, time is on UI fade out. I do not have my splits running, so I'm not exactly sure what the time was there, but if I take a glance over at the stream, it's looking like it is a 15.
Yeah,
1548, roughly?
1550 is what I had on the timer, but I may have been a second off.
This is why we use auto splitters, folks. Auto splitters are nice.
GG on that interesting squad run.
Interesting is a good way to put it. I know that there's one other speedrunner, I think, on for Two Island Hard custom mode. I think they use the Techno Hornets mech instead of what we normally go with. Which I
Interesting
think
choice.
is. I don't think that's faster on easy, but for hard, it makes sense because of the extra mobility.
Yeah, okay, I can see that. Yeah, hard, you mobility is king on hard.
Still, that
I'm
went surprisingly smoothly.
Yeah. GG on that for sure.